with Jennifer Lopez. I love that I can sort of follow what's going on in your life on Twitter. And I know you tweeted this photo of this huge rack of dresses before the Golden Globes. Wow. That's not your closet, right, Jennifer?
No.
These are just your choices for the Golden Globes?
Yes. My status bought over all these dresses.
Wow.
And it's funny. I was like, let's tweet this. This is crazy insane. Nobody's going to believe this. You know, I still don't believe it sometimes. I'm like, when did all this happen? This is crazy.
But it must have been so much fun and so much pressure, too, to pick out something to wear because you're photographed by a million photographers. You're plastered all over the world in whatever you're wearing. Does that stress you out a little bit?
I have a lot of fun with it.
I'm starting to get stressed thinking about it.
You know, it's funny. I was at Good Morning America, and I was there was all the photographers, you know, through the windows and stuff. And the guy, somebody asked me, they're like, doesn't that freak you out just a little bit? And I was like, it can if you let it. But I don't let it because I look at it as like love. I don't look at it as anything else, you know?
Aren't you worried that someone's gonna take your picture and trash your dress? That's what I would worry about.
No.
I wish I had your confidence. It's fantastic.
I mean, yes, there's always that possibility. And trust me, I've been on, you know, the what is she doing? You know what I mean?
Who wore it better? Not her.
Yeah. She sucked.
Yeah, no. Let's take a look. I liked it. I hope everyone else did. I thought your dress was beautiful at the Golden Globes. Let's take a look at the dress you selected. I like that faux see-through. See-through effect where it looks like you're just wearing lace, but we know, of course,
you've got
a flesh-colored gown underneath. Tell us about that dress and why you picked it.
Well, Zuhair Mourad is actually, he did all the costumes for my tour. I've been wearing his dresses for a few years now. It was funny, I was doing a private show in Russia somewhere, middle of the night, totally jet lag on Fashion TV, which is a channel they have in Europe, where they just show runway shows. And there was this runway show, and I was like, who is this guy? These dresses are amazing. This is so different. It's so edgy, so new. And it was this guy, Zuhair Mourad. And we started calling him and saying, send us dresses. And since then, we've been working together. And, you know, this is very much his style. If you saw the tour costumes as well, it kind of has a similar feel, this particular dress. But I don't know. He sent a few over. The black one I wore afterwards was also his, which is a very different style.
And, do you have to actually wear something there and then you have to change for the after parties?
You don't have to, but this dress for me was just like tight.
Yeah.
I like to be more relaxed afterwards in the party. So with this one, the other one was kind of like backless and loose on the bottom, and it was actually more fun to dance with. I was, you know, doing my whole thing. Having a little bit of fun, mommy's night out, you know. So
at the Golden Globes themselves, and by the way, we should say that Beau looked very pretty smoking in his white ensemble as well.
Nice.
Black and white is very big this year.
Is it? Yes, we were so on trend.
Yeah, we're so trendy. But you ran at the Golden Globes themselves. You ran into a few old friends.
Oh God, you have to bring this up.
Oh, come on, let me ask you about it because I thought about it for you as I was watching the Golden Globes at home in my pajamas. And you were looking so nice. But you ran into P. Diddy at the Golden Globes. We have that, an old flame. Also, Ben Affleck. When you saw that you were going to be in their space, were you like, awkward?
No. I know I'm saying no to everything, but that's how I feel today.
Well, that's good. I think you should be honest. I mean, so...
The answer is...
Were you a little bit like,
No, because we run in the same circles. I do see them. You know, probably... the world doesn't know that I see them. I don't know, hey, I just ran into Diddy today. I don't tweet that kind of stuff. But I do run into them, you know, every so often.
So did you... Was it... I mean,
so this was not a big, like, oh, my God, you know?
Even for Ben and you?
No. We talk and, you know, we email, more email than anything.
So you guys are on really good terms and all that. And were you happy for him?
I was
happy because I happen to love Argo.
I was so happy for him. You know, like I said, and I've said this before, you know, we had such a hard time, the press and the movies, and they were like, oh, this is all their careers, this and that. And to look at myself and to look at him now and to have him, he's won Best Picture at the Golden Globes, that he directed the movie. It's like, yes, I'm happy for him. I'm happy for you. This is a great thing. So, yeah, I gave him a standing ovation and felt really I don't know, kind of like, wow, good.
I think it was special, too, because he really got snubbed by the Oscars. He didn't even get nominated.
He got nominated for Best Picture at the Oscars, too.
But not nominated for Best Director, and a lot of people thought that
should have
happened. You
know what? You win some, you lose some. I think he's okay.
Yeah.
He won the Film Critics, Best Director, Best Actor. He won at the Globes that night. He's nominated for Best Picture. He's nominated for an Oscar for one of the Best Pictures of the year that he directed and starred in. It's okay. It's okay. That's amazing.
Yeah. Now, before we go to break, I just want to ask you about American Idol. Have you been watching it? Do you miss it?
I do miss doing the show. I had such a good time doing it. It was no secret. I've said it a million times.
Meanwhile, it's probably nice to be away from all the drama. Because there's a lot of drama, I understand, on
that
show.
I haven't seen the first two episodes. It started last week. I'm kind of glad I didn't see it because everybody's asking me about it. So I can honestly say I haven't seen it. But I do miss it. I do miss it. I liked it a lot. And, you know, I wish them the best always.
Well, I know one of the reasons you left the show was so you could concentrate on your acting. And let's face it, taking your clothes off in front of Jason Statham.
Yeah.
Not too shabby.
Lucky him.
It's
the leather.
All right, we're going to be talking with you and Jason. Hello.
Up next, how J-Lo's new...
We don't have enough men on this show. I got to be honest. So I'm very excited to say, please welcome Jason Statham.
Fun?
Yeah, so nice to finally meet you. And I've read about you and seen lots of pictures of you.
Okay.
But nice to have you here in person. So you had to, this must have been a very challenging role to have Jennifer take off her clothes in front of you and spin around.
You start with that one, right?
They all start
with that.
Well, it's sort of hard not to because, first of all, I think every man watching it wishes they were you. Every woman is terrified to be Jennifer because you have to, you get down into the skivvies.
I was terrified to be Jennifer.
Yeah. Was that hard? I would rather have each fingernail pulled out one by one than to have to do that in real life, much less in a movie.
Yeah, it's nerve-wracking. You know it's coming. It's nerve-wracking. You just like, you just have to suck it up.
Yeah. I heard you starved yourself for a few days and had McDonald's waiting for you after the scene.
Absolutely.
You did?
That's right.
So tell me.
So you're running down the stairs with a bag.
Really?
That was in the bag. She went, go away.
So how did you enjoy making this movie and how did you like working with Jennifer?
It was terrific. We had a really great director.
Taylor Hackford
is he's fabulous. So we had a great man at the helm.
It's very violent. I mean, you get beaten up pretty badly in this movie, don't you?
Yes, I do, yes. Yeah.
Just part of the job. And you play this thief, a character from a novel who has been played before in other movies. I think Lee Marvin played him, and also Mel Gibson as well.
Yes, Lee Marvin played him in a movie called Point Blank, and Mel Gibson in a movie called Payback. But Donald Westlake wrote, 24 novels about this character. So comes from a great literary background.
Jennifer, you play a woman who is divorced.
Yes.
Who's a sort of a struggling real estate agent.
Right.
You actually made this movie when you were going through your own divorce. So was that weird to have sort of art imitating life in that case?
It was kind of perfect, to be quite honest, because I was very in touch with all the emotions. I play a character who's really literally at the worst point of her life. Like you said, she's divorced. You know, in her mind, she's pushing 40. She's,
living with her.
Work is not going well. Living with her mom.
And Patti LuPone.
Yeah, who's
so
amazing.
Annoying. Because she's supposed to be.
Yeah. But she's amazing. And so she's at the worst point in her life. And at that moment when I was doing the movie, I felt the same way. It was the worst time of my life, going through the divorce with the kids and the whole thing. And so it actually was kind of a blessing in disguise, as these things can be sometimes, to be able to use all those emotions and all those feelings and air, because, you know, when you have kids and you have to get up every day, and it's so hard to get up when you're feeling that sad. You have to kind of hide it, work and hide it in front of the kids, and so to have be able to use it in the scene, look like how I felt, was great for me.
Yeah. And I know that it's interesting, Jason, because I think there's a lot of chemistry, obviously, between you, but Jennifer is not your love interest. I mean, she doesn't get the guy in the movie, right?
I know. It's very disappointing for me. Taylor wouldn't change that, no matter how I insisted. He said no.
Jason, I think it's so cool. You have such an interesting backstory in terms of how you were discovered. You were selling fake jewelry on the street with your dad.
You don't know this story?
On the streets of London.
I look at your jewels all the time.
So no, tell us about how you were discovered, because it's so crazy.
Yeah, I used to work. You know, there's a big store called Harrods in London.
I'm familiar with it.
Me too.
I used to work outside Harrods with, four or five stooges sitting on a milk crate with a briefcase selling fake jewelry. And that's how I earned a living ever since I left school. So I did that right up until the point where I met a guy called Guy Ritchie, who was making a movie.
Was married to Madonna, director, right?
Yes. Yeah. He was making a movie about sort of street hustlers and criminals and crooks. And I kind of fit straight into the shoes of one of the characters. And
That's crazy.
Yeah.
And isn't that crazy?
So I did an audition. And then it got me the part. And from, that was a dozen years ago.
Isn't that weird how you could
Something's
be hustling,
are meant to be.
You know, fake jewelry in front of Harrods, and suddenly, boom, you meet one person and your life changes forever?
Yeah. I'm in acting class. I'm taking dance classes. I'm going to 55,000 auditions. And he's sitting there selling jewelry, and this guy's like, hey, you want to star in my movie?
Yeah. It just works out that way for some people. Well, up next, we're going to find out why there are so many pictures of Jason in a Speedo. How's that for a tease?
What?
Still to come, Grammy-winning Latin rocker Juanes performs.